السلام عليكم. I think we'll start our third session. Our third session will be about national screening program. It's my pleasure to introduce our moderator, Dr. Hussein Shaban, consultant neonatologist, and the head of the Department of Pediatric in Maternity Children Hospital, Dammam. And second speak moderator, Dr. Abdurrahman Al-Mahiri, consultant neonatologist from Military Hospital, Khamis Mshed.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It's a great pleasure for us both to moderate this session and to share with you also the scientific. First of all, I'd like to thank organizing committee and scientific committee who has done all effort to get a success and to reaching just only the knowledge. Morbidity and mortality has decreased in the last decade significantly. But still, there is a lot of things to be concerned because reachable, achievable services is not everywhere the same in the same country. Some of the higher level, some of the low level, this is why different result. It is really great pleasure to introduce Dr. Fahad, who is doing his effort for equalification, actually, for the services in Saudi Arabia, and to get the service equal in all areas in Saudi Arabia. As we have seen in some discussion, there are different way of result. Dr. Fahad, consultant of neonatologist and head of department in Riyadh National Hospital. By the way, he is the director of neonatal services improvement program in Ministry of Health. And we'd like to welcome Dr. Fahad in this session. Thank you very much.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Good afternoon, everybody. And I want to thank the organizing committee for inviting me for this session. This afternoon, I will talk about the developing and improving neonatal services in Ministry of Health and our journey on this project. You know, to start with, saving a newborn life is really a challenge. And to give you the stories and numbers, you need to know that the 2 million is the number of babies who could be saved each year if we end preventable newborn mortality. 1.2 million is the number of stillbirth in 1 year, in 2012, where heart stopped during labor. And 1 million is the number of babies who died and did not survive the first day of their life. 2.9 million, they did not survive during the or complete 28 days in 2012. And 6.6 million is the number of children who died before they reached their fifth year in 2012. And unfortunately, there is a 40 million lady across the world who give birth each year without any help from midwives or trained people. Unfortunately, 2 million of them reported that they give birth without any help. So the story is really sad. Both neonatal mortality rate and infant mortality rate are global standards as an indicator for measuring and monitoring health in any country. And this is well known. It is documented in the WHO documents. And in between 2000 and 2015, it was clearly mentioned that if you want to reduce the infant or below 5 years deaths, you have to do something for the neonatal deaths. After 2015, and to plan for 2030, there was a meeting in the United Nations headquarters September 2015, and they agreed to continue what we call it sustainable development goals. And the most important is number three. Number three, talking about ensure health life and promote well-being for all at all ages. And out of goal three, the most important for us here is the 3.2 by 2030, end preventable deaths of newborn and children under 5 years of age, with all countries aiming to reduce neonatal mortality to at least as low as 12 per 1,000 live birth. So the journey should continue, and we have to do some work in improving this number. So we have a good number of babies delivering every year in Saudi Arabia. And we have people looking after this and reporting. We have international reports published every year and talking about neonatal deaths and what we are doing. There is documentation from different organizations, and even in the region, there is a publication which we have to be and reflect our work in a nice way. We have an office for the WHO in Saudi Arabia, monitoring the work and reporting our work in regards to the neonatal or pediatric development. So after this introduction, I will give you a few points about Saudi Arabia. As you know, 13 administrative area, and in 2016, the annual report, it was published that estimated population is more than 31.5 million, with an annual population growth of around 2%, and dropping in the total fertility rate to 2.6. Hospitals operated by Ministry of Health is 274, and hospital operated by private sectors and supervised by Ministry of Health is 145, and governmental hospitals operated by non-MOH, 43 hospitals. We have in Saudi Arabia around 600,000 delivery every year, and in Ministry of Health we have around 260 or more than 260 delivery every year. This number actually is static over the last few years, since 2012 till 2015, and the data we get from 2016 is almost talking about the same number. So we are in Ministry of Health in 270 hospitals, getting around 260-something babies every year, 1,000 babies. What about the WHO report about Saudi Arabia? Unfortunate, this is the publication from the WHO in 2015. We are the worst in the region, between the at least the Gulf region, and we have to do something. Although the numbers look good according to the international standards and requirement, but this is not good for us. And in one of the meetings, I get this document from the WHO in 2014, which indicate that 70% of our problem, if we want to improve the neonatal or the pediatric under 5 years deaths, we have to work on neonates, and 70% of the deaths are happening in the neonatal period. I will go back to 2011 in this meeting. In the 11th meetings, I was talking on this meeting about NICU standards in Saudi Arabia. And let me go through this before I join the Ministry of Health and start my project with them. The question that I throw on this meeting was, do we have a problem? And the first concern was the size of the problem is not clear. The decision makers in Ministry of Health are not fully aware of the huge problem in the NICU all over the Ministry of Health hospitals. We have bad, really, surface, and we have to know that we wish to be one of the best. The conclusion at that time was major concern about the quality of care delivered to the neonates in Ministry of Health hospitals. Identifying the problem is the first step in solving it, and we need years of hard, faithful work to overcome this problem. This is not from Saudi Arabia. But at that time, after the meeting, I saw one of the my colleagues, and he said, this is a nice dream. It is really, and this is our wish. So after that meeting, I communicate with the Ministry of Health, and we start evaluating the neonatal, the major, actually, neonatal ICUs in Ministry of Health. I visit 14 in ICUs, and we did an evaluation on the thorough evaluation on the vital statistic in ICU design, level of in ICU, medical equipment, medications, neonatal transportation, manpower quality and quantity, performance and quality improvement. There was an assessment approach starting from the leaders in the hospital to the NICU to collecting the data and comparing with the best practice on the internationally. Unfortunately, this was the result. Most of the hospitals or almost all the hospitals need urgent improvement in different, in the design, in the equipment, supply, manpower, training, care management, and statistic collection. So we summarized the report in 150 pages to Ministry of Health, and we summarized it in one page for the leaders. So the size of the problem was clear for everybody in Ministry of Health, and this was the first point. And there was a clear need for improving the service at that time. So what the first thing did is establishing a neonatal service improvement program fully funded by Ministry of Health, and formulating the committee, Ministry of Health and Neonatology Advisory Committee, to lead and monitor the change. And the members are doctors, nurses, respiratory therapists, biomedical, engineer, education, and different services in the Ministry of Health. Since that time, we start meeting every 2 months to review and evaluate the services. And this is maybe with this photo, I will stop to say, يعني, rahmatullah alayh, we missed our colleague, Dr. Abu Saleh, Basamad, Dr. Basamad, who passed away, and he was one of the very active members in that committee. So we divided the Saudi Arabia to 5 zones, and we put one of the senior doctors leading the change and reporting in that region. We established more than 40 improvement projects, all to improve the mortality and morbidity. We submit our projects to the Strategy Implementation Office and Ministry of Health to classify and prioritize the projects according to the importance and the urgency of those projects. I will not go through all the projects, but I will summarize most the most important projects out of these different. The guideline for neonatal, we published our guideline, including, and it was published and distributed, more than 1,700 copies distributed to all the hospitals in the Ministry of Health and outside Ministry of Health hospitals, and it became the reference for Ministry of Health. We formulate a committee to update the definitions and indicators. So we update and unify general definitions and indicators used in the neonatology. For example, definition of abortion, stillbirth, viability, age, and so on, all approved in Ministry of Health and later on approved in the Saudi Council and approved all in the other hospitals also. We start the vital statistics registry, registering all the, in collaboration with the Ministry of Interior, including all the data, the vital statistics about every delivery. And now we are working with the Ministry of Interior on the food stamp also to identify babies on delivery and on discharge, and to compare and to compare and to reduce the errors which can happen on discharge by sending the baby to the wrong family, by a unified or really a unique program which we are working now on it, and hopefully we will start the pilot study soon in 5 hospitals. The other project is leveling of NICU. We select 30 level 3 units in over all the country in the Ministry of Health, and we start expansion and redesigning the neonatal units. This was one of the busy units in the Ministry of Health, and with the expansion and redesigning of all the referral units, we finish almost more than 370 bed renovation now. And this is one of the some of the photos that we just finished or opened from. This is in Abha, the previous one in Najran. This is in Bureida, 83 bedded neonatal, huge neonatal ICU for the whole Al Qasim area. And this is in the neonatal ICU in Dammam, more than 100 bedded neonatal ICU. Referral center for Dammam area. Equipment standardization, it was like a shopping list. The doctors will request and the Ministry of Health will reply. We put a standard list according to the unit size and according to the level of care. Then for 500 bedded referral hospital, there is a list for 200 bedded hospital. Small hospital, there is another list. So, and accordingly, the equipment will be approved. Neonatal transport system was approved by Ministry of Health, and soon, hopefully in 2018, we will start the pilot study, inshallah, our pilot in Al Qasim, and then Dammam area is the next. So hopefully in this year, we will start. Consumable and medication standardization, and this was a major concern. We put a manual specific for neonatal ICU, and which was published, and now all the Gulf region are utilizing this manual and using it. And also we published our neonatal dosage and practical guidelines, and I want to thank the authors, Dr. Salih Al-Alayan and Najwa Al-Ghamdi, who helped us on putting together this manual. Regarding the consumable, also we divide it to urgent and non-urgent. Furthermore, we put the manual with the photos, so it will be easy for the nurses to request according to the photo and the code and to make it easy for her. Training programs, we put 23 standard basic competency for the nurses, and they start on the training competency for all the neonatal ICU nurses. We are working with the Saudi Neonatology Society now on the Saudi Neonatal Resuscitation Program, instructors and provider courses. We are working also with the stable we have already more than 50 instructors in Saudi Arabia, which is the largest number of instructors outside the state. And we are disseminating this course all over the Saudi Arabia, and we get an approval of diploma degree for nurses to graduate the leaders for NICU. Manpower standardization also is there. We put a standard for the doctors, nurses, and respiratory therapists working in neonatal ICU. And we worked on protocols. We published more than 70 in ICU policy for nurses, and we work with the Saudi Neonatology Society on the guidelines, medical guidelines, and we work with the, now we are implementing the metabolic screening. We are implementing the retinopathy of prematurity examination, a guideline for treatment of phototherapy, unified, and unified protocol for feeding premature babies, unified protocol for respiratory RSV prophylaxis, and we are implementing CCHD screening and hearing screening universal for all deliveries in Ministry of Health. To improve the performance, we also have an on-call senior doctors 24/7 all the year to answer the small hospitals in the Ministry of Health. For the doctors, they can get this help by calling the on-call doctor for any concern. Furthermore, we assigned visiting neonatologists to the different units So we, and this is still open, we have 15 small or medium units now covered with the visiting, regular visiting consultant, and we are recruiting more visiting consultant, certified neonatologist will visit this unit and improve and upgrade the service there. Also, the quality performance monitoring, we start this year collecting KPIs on every referral units, the 30 in ICU, 20 KPIs collected every month and analyzed in Ministry of Health. In the private hospital also, the private sectors, we are periodically evaluating the neonatology services by Ministry of Health teams, and also this is, we are reviewing their performance. At the end, I want to go back to this slide. We are not happy about the number still. We are on the journey, and hopefully our time is 2020 to see different numbers on this table, inshallah. It was a dream, but a dream written down with a date become a goal, and a goal broken down into steps become a plan, and a plan backed by action make your dream comes true. Thank you for the team working with me, and thank you for you.
Thank you, Dr. Fahad.